This should have been what I'm listening to from the inception of the channel. I should have introduced myself to damn Black Sabbath way earlier on. What's going on? Hope y'all are having a dope ass day today. It's your boy Alex and I'm back today with another reaction video, and I'm wearing my unreleased demonetized demon shirt.
I want that.
It's the perfect opportunity to listen to the song we're about to listen to. Obviously, you've seen the title, you've seen the thumbnail, you've seen the video, you clicked on it, you're here, you know what to expect. Black Sabbath.
What?
Returning to our album reaction of Black Sabbath, the song we got today is called NIB. I did do a little bit of research on the song, and I found something particularly intriguing. I found that the title of the song was long rumored to be an acronym for Nativity in Black, a reference to the birth of the Antichrist. The lyrics are also from the point of view of Lucifer, who identifies himself. The rumors turned out to be wrong, however. Butler later referred to it as, quote, just a humorous take on Satan falling in love. Ozzy and Lamy also stated that, quote, the title has nothing to do with the content of the song. So, let's jam the song and see if we can form an opinion for ourselves, shall we? So let's freaking get it, lads! Link to the original video will be down below in the description. Y'all make sure to check it out if you want to. And let's go, man. Black Sabbath. And for those of y'all that don't know, maybe you're just tuning in to this channel for the first time, maybe you saw me pop up and you're recommended, but if you did not know, my dog, right here, isn't he cute? Named Ozzy, after, yes, the Prince of Darkness himself. We call him the Prince of Barkness. Anyway, let's get it. I don't think I've ever seen a Sabbath performed live video. Oh. Oh. That is the core start. We're starting this over. That is the fucking coolest thing I've ever heard. Dude, that is fucking sick. We gotta turn this one up. He's such an icon, dude. Ozzy Osbourne is such an icon.
No shit, Sherlock.
Tell me how I have over 1,000 videos on my channel, and this is the very first time I'm hearing this song. This should have been what I'm listening to from the inception of the channel. I should have introduced myself to damn Black Sabbath way earlier on. Secondly, hearing music like this, it makes me want to grow my damn hair out, start wearing black nail polish, and just start living life like Ozzy. What would Ozzy do?
I pictured it. It was a real bass. You know?
Was it alive?
Well, it was till I bit the head of it, you know?
I need a damn bracelet that says that. Last thing I'm gonna say before we jump back into the song is watching him do this in some weird way, and, you know, keep in mind that I haven't seen my dad, not to drop this bomb on y'all, but I haven't seen my dad since I was in sixth grade. But for some weird reason, I'm watching this and I feel like Ozzy's a damn father figure. I'm like, that's my dad. No real reason to feel like that. It's a weird sensation, but that's what I feel like, so. Thank you. I need to see him perform live, dude. It'd be such a shame to not. Couple things. First and foremost, I think it's very impressive that at this late in his career, he still sounds incredible. Like, his voice, it just doesn't change, right? It's just Ozzy Osbourne, man. It sounds so good. Second of all, I had a question for you guys. They showed close-ups of the guitarist playing, and he had, like, tape on his fingers. Now, I want to know why he did that. Does he have tape on his fingers because he's so blistered up from playing so much? Why the hell does he got a bunch of tape on his fingers? I don't know. Y'all drop a comment. Let me know. That's iconic, dude. That is so good. So good, dude. And I feel like it's interesting, right? Because Slipknot is the band that like really started and propelled the channel forward. So there was always a soft place in my heart for Slipknot. Metallica is a band that I've really grown to like, and I've listened to 3 full albums by them on the channel. So there are other bands out there, more so than Black Sabbath, that I know and that hold a special place in my heart. And I've told you guys that I need a heavy metal tattoo. At some point, I'm going to be getting a tattoo that is directly correlated to heavy metal. And my thing is, it would make much more sense to get like a Slipknot or Metallica tattoo, but for some reason I'm like, Black Sabbath, I want a damn Ozzy Osbourne tattoo. That'd be f***ing awesome. That'd be the coolest damn thing. And in my mind, it's just like the pure essence of heavy metal, the founders of it. Like, if there's a Mount Rushmore of... Hey bastard, I'm doing a Black Sabbath reaction. Don't interrupt me when I'm talking about Ozzy Osbourne.
Oh Lord, call me Esther.
You don't interrupt someone when they're talking about Ozzy Osbourne, damn it.
I like this guy.
Anyway, the founders, if there was a Mount Rushmore of metal, he's got to be on there. And for him to inspire bands that would come after him, Motley Crue, all those guys, it's insane. Not to mention, at the time that they came out with this music, it was like, people were listening to what? Other bands out there, like the Beatles and shit? There was nothing this intense. There was nothing this dark, this twisted. It really kind of, I like this word, polarized society of you're like the Black Sabbath type of dude or you're like the Beatles type of dude, I think. I remember my mom growing up saying, No, I don't. I've heard that whenever she was growing up, she didn't really listen to Sabbath that much. But dude, if I was raised on this, be way cooler than I am now, I can tell you that much. But with that being said, that's where you guys come in. Drop some comments down below. Let me know what you think about this song, NIB and the Prince of Darkness himself. With that being said, keep smiling, keep being yourself. Don't let anybody throw shade at you. I will see you guys tomorrow. That's a motherfucking fact though, yeah. I love y'all. Peace. Don't believe the lies deceive.